First up, fighting out in the red corner, fighting out of Carlson Gracie Gym, is Tommy Yip. Up next, fighting in the blue corner, former UFC fighter, Phil Harris.
No surprises which part of this song we're waiting for, ladies and gentlemen. So our third match of the evening, Tommy Yip in the black gi representing Carlson Gracie, taking on Phil Harris in the white gi. He is representing Gym 01. From down in Portsmouth. And as you rightly mentioned in the intro, John, Phil Harris, a former UFC competitor.
Very fitting he came out to Bubba O'Reilly, eh?
Absolutely. An early guard pull from Tommy Yip. One thing that a lot of people might not know about Phil Harris, he has a massively extensive judo background. Really puts a lot of effort into the throws, but he's going searching for a footlock early here.
Sitting back there, I mean, Tommy's a primary gi player and very much a back, plays on his back a lot. Very good rim blows and very dynamic off his back.
Yeah, I mean, obviously a very extensive and high-level MMA career for Phil Harris, so a lot of grappling, no gi. It's really good to see him go back to the gi and keep that competitive energy up once he stopped fighting professionally. And happy to step up on competitions like this, finding himself in the closed guard now. And you can bet one thing he's definitely carried over from his MMA days is the ability to nullify an opponent on the bottom. Really sit on them, make yourself heavy.
I mean, that's what he's going to get from his judo background as well, Josh. He's very good base up on top. I mean, and recently as well, he's come back into the gi competitions now.
Yeah, high guard from Tommy Yip. Just putting Phil Harris in a little bit of danger there with the legs and spider guard now.
I mean, a totally different styles here, totally different mode of styles here. But
absolutely.
Phil goes into the back, kind of goes out quite easy there.
That was a lovely sweep from Tommy Yip to earn the top position here. He's looking to pass, showing almost a little bit of disdain for Mr. Harris in the grip break there.
There's a bit of how dare you touch me there.
So, Harris looking to try and engage a hook with that ankle grip, see if he can find some sort of guard.
Phil going into deep half now.
Well, it's a good connection from Tommy Yip on top, but he chooses to open up and he's going to try and pass standing here.
Phil comes up.
Oh, jumping back tape from Tommy Yip.
Beautiful.
Yeah, that's one thing you find from the guys this light. They tend to move very quickly, but good guard recovery from Phil Harris. And he's trying a lot of open guard work, and Yip is just dancing around him here. But we'll see what happens if he grips him up standing. Could be a different ball game.
Tommy's looking to put on a show here.
It's a smart game from him so far, you know? He's trying to get in his opponent's head. He's not allowing Phil Harris to implement probably his strongest area of grappling, which will be the stand-up clinch.
Oh, triangle attempt here. Phil's staying very, very postured.
Yeah,
Tommy needs to break this posture to get this triangle. He's pulling down on his...
Well, I can't quite see the grips, but Phil's done a good job of getting his spine in line, getting his head straight, and that is going to be problems for him.
Oh, here it is. He needs to get that Tommy's right leg.
Well, it's very tough for us to see what's happening with the arms from the position where we are, but there's a few things that could be going on here, and Phil Harris is trying to regain that posture. If he can get his head up, keep himself based above his hips, it gives him a lot more pressure to fight that very strong rowing motion from Tommy Yip, who is looking to lock this up now.
Again, great base there from Phil. Adrilo background certainly helping right now. Oh.
Oh, he's over the foot, so not quite locked. He's trying to cinch it a little bit tighter.
I think Tommy needs to just get his hips further away a little bit, just to give a little bit of space so he can really lock that triangle in.
Yeah, we can also see that Phil Harris has got his right arm fairly buried to the mat, so you can bet there's a little bit of space on that carotid artery still remaining. You can see he's managed to force the legs back to this crooked guard position.
I mean, the thing is about this position here is that Tommy just can't burn out his legs.
Well, that's it, isn't it? We've got a long time still to go in this match. And you've got to bet the lactic is starting to build up, and could be a moral victory for Phil Harris escaping that one.
And he comes back. I mean, is Tommy going to be tired now from that? It doesn't look like it to me, though. He looks very calm.
Playing a very open game. It's the second time he's tried that spider guard to the grip break, back to the Deliver on the other side. Oh, coming up for an armbar here. You can see Phil's trying to create that frame, force both arms back in, and very wily. Over underpass now for Harris.
Looking for the guard pass now, Phil. Remember, I know that these are submission only fights, Josh, but the basis of points is better position. And I think you should try and play that points game into and come into a better position so you can get these submissions on.
Well, there's almost no downside to having a dominant position, is there?
Definitely not.
So looking to work in the close guard again here, and Harris is going to have to be wary. We've already seen a couple of times the Carson Gracie man, Tommy Yip, in the black gi, really throw up some of those fantastic submission combinations.
Feel very strong on top, though.
So just keeping his head in the center. We're going to break the grip. Strong collar grip for Tommy Yip now, and you see immediately those legs are looking to go to work. A lot of fantastic matchups also coming your way tonight. UK MMA old school legend Lee Remedios taking on Paul Bridges later on. That'll be a fantastic match. Our main event tonight, Greg Creel, Chris Regan in a great black belt matchup. A lot to look forward to here at the Tough Invitational. I hope you're enjoying the live stream on our YouTube channel. Special announcement coming later about Tough Invitational 3.
A very big one at that. Very big one at that.
Yeah, something to look forward to, but it's looking for an Ezekiel choke from the bottom here, back to the triangle. And you see, at the moment, I just get the feeling that Tommy is giving Phil so many things to think about. It's very hard for Harris to implement his game and what he wants to do. And at the moment, the style and the pace is being dictated by Tommy as he goes searching for an omoplata there.
Phil was very privy to that omoplata there. But what we're seeing is Phil really defending at the moment, not really having a chance to attack at all. Tommy very, very active, attacking gi chokes, arm bars, and a triangle earlier.
Yeah, absolutely. He's the busier of the two men here. Again, going to work on that spider guard. You can see Phil has the grips he wants to fight the leg positions, and he manages to settle back down.
Almost went right into a triangle there.
I've got to say, at the moment, I get the feeling the momentum is really with Tommy Yip. Again, he goes to rock and attack that overhook on the left side. It's been a fantastic weapon for him so far.
Tommy doesn't look to be getting frustrated either. I mean, every single submission attempt he's putting up, I mean, Phil's just slapping it away. But not really looking like he's too urgent at the bottom. Just throwing up a triangle or an armbar attempt whenever he sees it. But they need to start working. I think time is starting to
what a fantastic combination. Look to take Phil all the way over the top. And when Phil based back, he shot the legs up to threaten the triangle again. Very tricky guard from Mr. Yip here.
The old classic hip up triangle there. Both guys looking really hot. He must be very hot under those.
Yeah, I mean, we can't stress, ladies and gentlemen, how hot it is here in the Circus Tavern. The UK reaching record temperatures in the last week. And of course, a full fanfare of lights, cameras, and an audience to cheer these competitors on tonight. Our referee, Thiago Borges, overseeing this one. Again, your commentators for the evening, John Jarvis and myself, Josh Palmer. We'd also like to thank our sponsors for the evening. Tough Fightwear, Valor Fightwear. Oh.
Phil gets his arm, his elbow out, then the rest of his arm.
Yeah, the omoplata was threatened there as well by Yip as he looked to go inverted. His cross guard game is really something to worry about. You can see this posture, typically it's not something you'd see many fighters do, but Phil's got to do something to try and pin Yip down and at least instigate some form of his own game here, because right now it's all Tommy Yip.
I mean, Tommy's come on a long way in such a short time. Well, footlock attempt here by Phil, and he comes back out of it. But yeah, Tommy's come on so well. I've known Tommy since he first started doing jiu-jitsu. He was a very close student to Claudio Silva, the UFC fighter, and they won tough grappling competition. Tommy went to sleep under a choke because he didn't want to fall asleep. He didn't want to tap out in front of Claudio. Did not want to tap. That's the type of guy that Tommy is. He's very, very respectful of his coaches, and went to sleep for it.
So, obviously, this is a couple of times now we've seen Phil Harris look to attack these footlocks, and it might be a good game for him. It means, omoplata, and exploding out is Phil Harris. Back to the feet. Let's see if he can. Well, let's expect Tommy Yip to pull guard again. There we go. What I was going to say was we're seeing Phil Harris attack more of these footlocks, and what it's going to do is it's going to at least open up the game a bit more, and maybe he can get a pass from it, maybe he can create a scramble, because right now what he doesn't want to be is sitting in the closed or active open guard of Tommy Yip.
Exactly that. I mean, Tommy's gym, Carson Gracie Kent, are very known for their footlock attempts. You've got Taylor Pierman, who is a teammate of his, who is a competitor in Tough Invitational 1, who won by footlock. So I'm guessing he's used to it.
You see Alain Pozzo running the Carlson Gracie crew down in Essex in the corner
there.
Of Tommy Yip, making himself very well heard.
Alain's doing a great job there in Carlson Gracie Essex.
Yeah, he's
some really good fights.
Cultivating a really good team of young, up-and-coming competitors. And at the moment, Tommy Yip, I'm just so impressed with the activity in his guard. Well, Phil looking to stop that left leg from coming out. Now looking to step for the over-under. Let's see if he can get a stack pass off it. He tries. He's got to get the head up as he turns around.
We have 4 minutes and 20 seconds remaining here.
Oh, a bit of inverted guard retention from Tommy Yip.
Yeah, 4 minutes, just over 4 minutes remaining here. So we're at the 11-minute mark, and the guys look like they're not tired.
Well, it's going to be interesting to see as we go into the final minutes how that cardio starts playing a role. Again, lovely fluid guard retention from Tommy Yip, and a strong grip break on the leg there.
Eduardo Goncalves, Tommy's instructor, has been very, very specific what he wants. He wants Tommy to sweep, which he's just done, pass, take the back, and choke him. That's what he's shouting out.
Well, that's easier said than done.
I know.
Tommy Yip with the top position now. Kind of the first time we've seen Phil Harris spend any amount of time on his back here. Looking for.
Yeah,
looked as though he's going
to.
Looked as though he was going to reap the leg. As we mentioned, all the fights tonight taking place under IBJJF rules, but with the one modification of knee reaping is allowed, and there is no effect on the fighters for it.
We could be going to the first draw of the night here. I mean, Tommy is very, very active with his submissions, but just swatting them away right the
floor. It's not for a lack of trying, but as we've said a couple of times already, John, if you don't get that sub, it really doesn't matter.
Exactly that.
That's it, monitoring the legs very well. Now he tries to stack pass again, and he's got to put these together with the step over the other leg. But this kind of flexibility and dexterity. Oh!
Straight into a triangle, and feels privy to it again and stops it.
Well, wouldn't that sweep have been quite something? Roberto Abreu would have been very proud.
Very calm for which we have 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining.
One thing I'm very impressed with is how dominant the grips of Tommy Yip have been. I really honestly thought Phil Harris might have an edge in the grip breaking just from the judo background. Oh, they're calling for the Toriando pass to side control, making himself very heavy in this half guard.
Tommy just needs to be a bit more heavy on top here, I think.
Yeah, we're into the last 2 minutes here, and you can see they've upped the pace a little bit. Phil Harris in on that straight arm bar, looking to use it to sweep. Nice knee slide pass from Tommy Yip, and he's all the way around looking to take the back. Phil Harris has got a scramble here. You can bet he's going to be comfortable in that turtle position. Almost. Yeah. Well, watch that. He's got to watch that arm.
Back take there.
Minute and a half. Armbar coming. Phil's going to have to sit up here if he allows that leg to come over the head and pin him down. Oh, and we're down to just the fingertip grip now. Tommy Yip looking to straighten it, but Phil Harris fighting with everything he's got. What a fantastic escape.
Great attempt there, and a great escape to equal it.
Amazing how we get down to the last minute of the match, and both guys suddenly turn it up, shooting for the triangle now, legs climbing high. The activity from these two fighters throughout has been something special.
And we have 45 seconds left, and they're both going at it still. Very good fight so far.
So again, in the last minute, Hail Mary footlock from Phil Harris. He's going to look to turn to the outside. I think he's only going to earn top position for this, though. And
so the match has stopped here with, I think, 2 seconds left.
Yeah, the referee just repositioning them. Calls Combacha, and we're off for the last exchange of the fight. Let's see if somebody can pull it out of the bag here. Both guys have been giving it their absolute all throughout this one. But I think we are going to see the first match from this evening go to the draw.
Nonetheless, a good match. I mean, sometimes it's boring draws and sometimes it's good fights.
Yeah, no complaints with...
And that's the end.
And we find ourselves at the end of 15 minutes, neither man able to pull out the submission. But what a fantastic display they put on for the fans here. And, of course, for you at home, Tommy Yip representing Carlson Gracie. And Phil Harris, representing Gym 01 in Portsmouth, have fought their way to a draw here. And I'm sure they'll be welcomed to a round of applause from the crowd.
Big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Our third match goes to a draw. Phil Harris and Tommy Yip.